10 different ASA brands. Are their properties very similar, or will we see some peaks? Welcome back. I have here 10 different ASA filaments, 4 different brands, and I want to see if there is any bigger difference between them. I already did something similar with PLA and PETG filaments. Now first I want to explain why ASA and not ABS. Well, ASA is newer filament type. It is UV and weather resistant, and we have less warping and less smell during the printing. Now ABS is older, but from this reason more popular, and usually it is cheaper and available in more colors. But I can see from more companies that the price is the same, so slowly this difference starts to disappear. What will I test? Well, the things which are important for the ASA over PLA or PETG. One of these is the temperature resistance in the oven. The second will be the creep test, and this time it will be completely outside, exposed directly to the sun. It is summer here, so 35 degrees Celsius the peaks, because this is what I want to test with ASA filaments. Also, I want to test the warping. On P1P, which is open printer, I'm not sure if I can measure something here or just analyze it visually, but I want to see if there is any bigger difference in the warping properties between these 10 filaments. Also, I want to test regular things like tensile strength and the layer adhesion with vertical printed objects with 2 watts and 20% infill. Not a solid one, maybe that will be for the article if there will be one. I know that color may have effect to these testings too, but I believe the difference is not too big here. But I am working with what I have, and just a small reminder, if I will create a video which will have 4,000 or 5,000 views, it will earn, let's say, $10. Only this Sunlu filament I bought to have 10 filaments in this testing, and it cost me $30, for example. And now the filaments, Qidi Tech ASA, and it is still in the box. Formfutura, this is Apollo X, it is also in the box. 3DO ASA, BambuLab ASA, Sunlu ASA in orange color, FlashForge ASA in white color, Polymaker ASA, AzureFilm ASA Prime, Prusament ASA, eASA in black color, and this one is from the eSun. Sometimes it is very hard to convince myself to do this kind of big works too. If I wouldn't be curious about it myself, probably I wouldn't do it. Big thanks to my Patreon supporters, basically they keep this channel alive, and thanks to their donations I'm able to do this kind of videos too. Objects in the slicer. For the layer adhesion I have 2 walls and 20% infill, rest test objects are solid inside. These are the print settings, 260 at the nozzle and 12 will be the flow rate. And here you can see the cooling settings, these are the default settings in the Bamboo Studio, and the printing time will be approximately 45 minutes. I'm starting with the Sunlu ASA, BambuLab, Polymaker ASA, Prusament, AzureFilm ASA Prime, 3DO, FlashForge, eSun, Qidi, Formfutura Apollo X. Printing of the test objects is finished, and I recorded each of them because I wanted to analyze the footage to show you the differences, but it was perfect printing every 10 times. Now one thing I noticed, even if the ASA has less smell compared to the ABS, but it was a little bit too much for this room. I have this pipe connected to the hole on the wall, but I think this exhaust fan on X1 carbon is not strong enough to push this air through this pipe. I think I have to install additionally inline fan at the end of the pipe. What is your experience about this? I worry a little bit about that warping test printing, because I wanted to do it on the open printer, on the P1P, but here this smell will be even stronger. Maybe I will just leave the printing and I will just check at the end and then ventilate the room, but this is something which I should supervise during the printing. Maybe I will just use the camera or something like that. We will get back to the warping test later when I figure out where will I print it. First I'm preparing some equipment for my creep test, and as I mentioned that I want to do this outside. The creeping is a deformation under the constant load, which will be 1.25 kilograms, and I'm measuring the distance between two reference surfaces. I already measured them, they have very similar deformation in all 9 cases, except on this one. Here we have huge deformation, I will show you the numbers in results part. So this will be the location for the test objects next 7 days. There is the sunrise, and the sunset is over there, so basically they will get the maximum number of the sun hours, and we will see after 7 days how much deformation we have on them. Here you can see the weather forecast for next 7 days. So 2 days will be extremely hot, over 35 degrees Celsius, and later there will be wind and rain, and I hope they will survive this 1 week, but we will see soon. Actually, you will see soon, I will see it only in 1 week. In the meantime, I want to show you this bench press is next to my test objects, and this is also printed from the ASA, and after a year now, it is still in perfect shape. See the ASA. This is day 4. Today will be very windy and it will create some additional load to them, but I can see they stop with their formation after 1 day, except on this one. This reacts like some kind of nylon. This is day 6, and I decided to stop the experiment 1 day earlier because tomorrow at this time before my workplace it will be a rain. Now visually I noticed that they stop with the formation after 1 day, and this is typical for most of the ABS or ASA filament. They stop with the creeping after this period. I already measured them. Here you can see their initial deformation, and this is the deformation after 6 days, and the difference between two is the creeping, and you can see it here. Now let's remove the loads. After my workplace in 10 hours I measured the permanent deformation, and also in the meantime I have to clean this hardened shaft. It is not really designed for outdoor use. Well, actually, I think there is no need to measure them because visually I can see they are perfectly equal, except this one. This is Formfutura, and I believe that this is some highly modified ASA for better printability, but they sacrifice some other properties here. With ASA material, we have that shrinking which results in the warping and also dimensional inaccuracy. So I measure it. This should be 80 millimeters design, 79.65. I measured each test object, and big average is 79.6 millimeters. This means approximately 0.5% of the shrinking. I'm not sure if the weight is important, but I will measure it. By the way, I'm not sure if you know that ASA has a smaller density compared to the PETG, so if you need lighter applications, this material is better. 3.155 grams. Unlike from the dimensions, here we have a few peaks between the numbers. I noticed that I have a serious peak here with AzureFilm and a smaller peak here with the 3DO, so I decided to measure one more test object, and this is this one for the impact test. Yes, we have the same ratio with these test objects too. The AzureFilm is heavier a little bit. I will show you the graphs later in the results part. By the way, these are a little bit thicker test objects, 6 mm, not 4. I will explain it later. The impact testing, and this may be one of the reasons why would you like to choose ASA instead of PLA or PETG. It is tougher material. And I have this machine from the eBay. I have a separate video about it. Currently its main problem is that these weights are too heavy for 3D printed plastic, even for the ASA. I'm waiting for the lighter ones, but so far I have these new test objects. Instead of 4 mm, I increased the thickness to 6 mm. I hope I can see some bigger difference between them, and also I'm hoping that I will be able to break all test objects, at least most of them. The zero position without test object. Sunlu. BambuLab. Polymaker. AzureFilm. Prusament. 3DO. FlashForge. eSun. Qidi. Formfutura. The numbers you saw on the screen are angle degrees. In results part, I will recalculate this to the joules breaking energy. Two objects didn't really break in this test, but even then I believe that this is a good comparison. The tensile tests with horizontally printed test objects, they are solid inside, 4 by 4 mm in the smallest cross-section area. And you can see the average values on the screen, but on the left side you can directly compare them with other materials. The strongest here was the AzureFilm, but now let's see the layer adhesion. These are vertically printed test objects, 10 by 10 mm is the smallest cross-section area, and it was printed with 2 walls and 20% infill. and this time the FlashForge was the strongest. I'm starting with the printing of the warping test, and I'll just start the printing and surprise of the camera. I have here air conditions, so the temperature will be very constant, and at the end I will just analyze the objects. This is my object for the warping test. It has very small contact surface, but it has overhangs, so the part cooling will be enabled, and it has bigger center, so it will stay attached to the bed. Looks like this method is too good. Maybe I can use it as a measurement, when will it fail? The warping test is finished and I have three groups here. In first group, the object is not finished, but I separate them if they are failed after or before 50%. In the second group, the object is finished, but with the warping. And again, I will separate if the warping is bigger or smaller. And the third group, it is completely finished and I have only two objects here. And I will show you now the final objects from the worst to the best. Sunlu and BambuLab failed before 50%, FlashForge failed but after 50%, and then Prusament, it was finished but with big warping. Then we have the Polymaker, eSun, Qidi, and 3DO. They are finished but with some warpings, and Formfutura and AzureFilm finished correctly without any warping. And exactly these two filaments have some low warping technology and it looks like it really works. The temperature test in the oven, where I want to record the temperature of the first deformation. M10 nut is a small load and usually the ASA starts to deform a little bit above 90 degrees Celsius. Well, more or less we can see this, only the Formfutura started to deform a little bit earlier, but the rest of them above 90 degrees Celsius. And for the filling, there is no big difference between them, only a little bit more shrinking I could see on Formfutura filament. 3-point bending test, and this equipment follows better the ISO 178 standard. Distance between supports is 64 mm and supports are rounded, diameter 10 mm in all 3 points. And with the PETG filament I used 2.5 kg load, but it was hard to measure any permanent deformation. So this time I will use 5 kg, which is a little bit too much, but I will follow the time and I will record the deformation after exactly half minutes. And then I will remove the load and I will see some kind of permanent deformation after another half minutes. Let's start with the bending after 30 seconds. Here I freeze the frame, but you can very easily follow the numbers on the left side on the graph. And this is a deformation 30 seconds after the load is removed, and on the left side again you can follow the changes. More or less very similar, except this last one, the Formfutura, but it looks like the deformation is not permanent, so now they are equally straight after this test. You already saw the graphs, but let's analyze them one more time. On the tensile test, the AzureFilm was the best and Formfutura was the weakest. On the layer adhesion test, here the FlashForge was the strongest. On the creep test, no significant difference between most of the test objects, only Formfutura was a little bit weaker here, and probably they sacrificed these kind of properties for better printability. On the temperature test, actually three objects start to deform before 90 degrees Celsius. This is the Formfutura, Polymaker and Prusament. On 3-point bending test, a very similar deformation in most cases. The FlashForge was the best here and Formfutura was the weakest. And a very similar ratio we can see when I remove the load, and this is after 30 seconds, some kind of permanent deformation. On the impact test, we can see very big spread in the breaking energy. Weakest here in this test was the AzureFilm, Prusament, FlashForge, Formfutura, and far the best was the eSun, and don't forget its breaking energy is even higher because the test object didn't break in this test. This is just a sad statistics of my TechFine YouTube channel trying to explain why you should click that notification bell button too, because regular subscribers are not informed in most cases. And on the warping test, here you can see my scoring table. So here the AzureFilm and Formfutura was the best without any warping, even on the P1P, which is open printer. And I'm not sure how important are these data. This is the shrinking test and this is the mass. So I measure it. If you are interested, you can see the results here. Now I promise you to find the best ASA filaments, and just for fun, I sort them in order from the best to the worst, and I give them the points from the 10 to 1. This is tensile test, layer adhesion, creep test, temperature test, bending test, impact test, warping test. Here I saw them in correct order, so sometimes we have a repeating of the points. And then we have this final table. So three best filaments are the FlashForge, 3DO and Qidi, and absolute champion is the 3DO. Maybe coincident, but exactly these three filaments has the lightest color in this test. Maybe the color have the effect to this kind of testing. Maybe I should test this separately. In the meantime, I'm preparing the test with the Polymaker ASA filaments, because this was your vote for this brand, to see the effect of the temperature and the part cooling to the layer adhesion. Shortly, I would like to answer to all those comments and messages I'm getting after this kind of videos, and that's why I don't rebuy all these filaments in the same color, why I don't have 5 test objects for each testing like CNC Kitchen have. Well, shortly I would like to answer with the numbers. My average views is 4,000, even if I have 54,000 subscribers, and the average money I earn from YouTube ads is $10 per video. And the costs, 3 from these 10 filaments I bought myself only for this testing. Actually, I don't need so many ASA filaments, and they cost me approximately $100. For example, I bought these Formfutura filaments. I got so many requests to test them. I contacted the company, but they didn't want to send them to me. So I have to buy it myself, the Apollo X, the Titan X, their ABS filament, the Volcano PLA, which can be annealed without some bigger shrinking, and I don't need so many filaments, but I became curious, and there will be a separate video about them. Let's talk about the time. 3D printing time was approximately 10 hours, additional 10 hours was the testing with the preparation, and then this video editing was one of the longest, 20 or 25 hours I needed for this. So basically I'm doing this mostly for myself, and if I need only 1 or 2 test objects, and then this is enough for my needs. And by the way, if you would like to get a notification about similar videos, definitely you should click that notification bell button too, because in most cases you can see that regular subscribers are not informed about my new uploads. And big thanks again to my Patreon supporters, because without them there will be very minimal activity on this channel. And now about these filaments. Unlike with the PETG, here we have a lot of peaks, but they are different from testing to testing. For example, if you need great layer adhesion, buy FlashForge. If you need anti-warping technology, then AzureFilm or Formfutura. But don't use that Formfutura if you have some creeping in your application. And don't forget the absolute impact resistance king is the eSun. But as you can see, there are still no perfect ASA filament, but I think we have a clear picture that there is a difference between the brands. And I'm curious, how much do you use the ASA filament? Give me some feedback in the comment section. Anyway, thank you for watching and happy printing!